Millfield. Millfield, let me... Millfield, let me break into your eager chatter. Thank you very much. On behalf of the Dean and the Chapter of Wells Cathedral, welcome. Welcome to those of you I can see and to those of you I cannot see, joined together tonight by the miracle of live streaming. Welcome to our service of carols and readings. Last month, Hindus and Sikhs celebrated Diwali, and now, as Christians prepare for Christmas, Jews are marking Hanukkah, their own distinctive festival of light. The first candle on the menorah was lit on Sunday. Light, like water, is a powerful and uplifting presence in most religions. In this service, we celebrate three successive seasons of the Christian calendar: Advent, Christmas, and Epiphany. Advent is about kindling light in the darkness, darkness that afflicts all of us. Christmas is a time for allowing Christ, the light of the world, to warm our hearts and enlighten our minds. In Epiphany, we take seriously the idea of being light for others. So tonight, let us then go to Bethlehem. Will you please stand? as we stand the bidding prayer, let us pray. Make clear to us, O Lord our God, the meaning of Christ coming to Bethlehem long ago, in our lives now and on the great last day, that we may receive forgiveness, know the light of his living presence, and rejoice in the hope of his kingdom. For his name's sake, amen. Please be seated. We gather then at this evening hour to contemplate again the deep mystery of Christ's coming to Bethlehem long ago, that most holy of nights. Jews, like Muslims, teach us that each new day starts not with sunrise, but at sunset. And there was evening and morning the first day. The night precedes everything. It falls and we rest. We rest and reflect. All's well that begins well. And so, before Christmas and Epiphany, comes Advent, the season of preparation.
Of A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For unto us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever.
B.C. A.D. This was the moment when before turned into after, and the future's uninvented timekeepers presented arms. This was the moment when nothing happened, only dull peace sprawled boringly over the earth. This was the moment when even energetic Romans could find nothing better to do than counting heads in remote provinces. And this was the moment when a few farm workers and three members of an obscure Persian sect walked, haphazard by starlight, straight into the kingdom of heaven.
Please stand to sing our second carol, O Little Town of Bethlehem. Will you please be seated?
A second reading from Isaiah. Hear now, you house of David. Is it not enough to try the patience of humans? Will you try the patience of my God also? Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and will call him Emmanuel. He will be eating curds and honey when he knows enough to reject the wrong and choose the right. The Spirit of the Lord will rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and of understanding, the Spirit of counsel and of might, the Spirit of knowledge and fear of the Lord, and he will delight in the fear of the Almighty.
Christmas time. 3, 2, 1, lift off. Signals mission control, and off they go to the dark parts of the planets in their pressurized spacesuits, cocooned in technology, the astronauts. Mission control whispers in someone's ear. Yes, she says, I will. And in due time, a different traveler makes a quieter journey, arriving hungry, naked, but true to instructions, docking on Earth, taking the one small step.
Have you noticed how all the best things in life begin with the letters CH? Chips, chocolate, cheese, Chaucer, chess, chapel, chipolatas, chives, chapel, chicken, chops, Chinese takeaways, chapel, chutney, Chelsea buns, chili, chapel, chestnuts, cherries, charity, chapel. I'm hoping the subliminal advertising might have some effect. But either way, perhaps we can add to the list Christmas and Christ, the one in whom God's light is completely present. And here's another sly CH, choir. They're pretty good too.
Thank you. Angel Delight, a reading from St. Matthew. This is how the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law, and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in his mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, and he said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife.
I am Joseph, carpenter of David's kingly line. I wanted an heir, discovered my wife's son wasn't mine. I am an obstinate lover, loved Mary for better or worse, wouldn't stop loving when I found someone else came first. Mine was the likeness I'd hoped for when the firstborn man-child came, but nothing of him was me, I couldn't even choose his name. I am Joseph, who wanted to teach my own boy how to live, my lesson for my foster son, endure, love, give.
Here is a short story. On Christmas Eve, Joseph rushes up to the innkeeper. "Please, please help me," he says. "My wife is about to have a baby." Unmoved, the innkeeper replies, "Sorry, it's not my fault." And Joseph goes, "It's not mine either." Away in a manger.
No room in the inn. A reading from St. Luke. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, as there was no place in the inn.
What the donkey saw. No room in the inn, of course, and not that much in the stable. What, with the shepherds, Magi, Mary, Joseph, the heavenly host, not to mention the baby using our manger as a cot, you couldn't have squeezed another cherub in for love nor money. Still, in spite of the overcrowding, I did my best to make them feel wanted. I could see the baby and I would be going places together.
While shepherds watch their flocks by night, please do stand to sing. Please be seated. And so from Advent and Christmas to Epiphany.
A reading from St. Matthew. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learnt from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out. And there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising.
The wise men and the star. The proper place for stars is in the sky, lighting the whole world, but negotiating only with the highly qualified: master mariners, astrophysicists, professionals like ourselves. This one came unscheduled, nudged us roughly out of routine, led us a wild goose chase, and perching here above unspeakable rafters, common as a starling on a washing line, whistles to every callow Dick and Harry idling amazed around. "Okay, pals, I've done my bit. Over to you now, Earth."
Tonight's offertory carol is Angels from the Realms of Glory. During this carol, offerings from the houses will be brought forward. Offerings that will be given to charities in Madagascar and Malawi, where we trust a little light will be shared. Will you please stand?
Thank you.
Please be seated.
A further reading from St. Matthew. When the wise men had heard the king, they set out. And there, ahead of them, went the star that they had seen at his rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. Seeing this, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they met the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And, having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road.
Not the millennium. Wise men are busy making computer literate. There should be a law against confusing religion with mathematics. There was a baby, born where and when. The sources mention massacres, prophecies, stars. They tell a good story, but they don't agree. So we celebrate at the wrong midnight. Does it matter? Only dull science expects an accurate audit. The economy of heaven looks for fiestas and fireworks. Every day, every day. Be realistic, says heaven. Expect a miracle.
Camerata now sing, softly through the winter's darkness shines a light. Christmas Night by John Rutter. peach, peach on earth. I hope you spotted that deliberate error. Some misprints are too good to correct. Peach on earth. What are the fruits of faith? 500 years ago, a cannonball smashed the leg of a young Spanish soldier, Inigo of Loyola, shattering his dreams of a military career. Instead, he adopted a new name, Ignatius, and founded the Society of Jesus, a Catholic order better known as the Jesuits. One fruit of faith is an awareness and appreciation of the surprises that shift our lives in new directions. As the science writer Isaac Asimov once noted, the most exciting thing to hear in a lab is not "Eureka, I found it," but rather, "That's funny." Numerous scientific breakthroughs have been sheer flukes, complete accidents, from pulses to penicillin, from Velcro to Viagra. And there's a word for this. There's a word for this, and the young soldier with the shattered leg learnt it. Serendipity. Serendipity. Stumbling upon something of unexpected importance. Indeed, one delightful Christmas movie goes by the same name, Serendipity. Do watch it. It's an apt title, for Christmas is defined by magic, miracles, and hope in the darkest of hours. Serendipity is celebrated too in the Christmas poems of U.A. Fanthorpe. As we have heard, these are quirky, irregular, with an unseen twist or gentle jolt. Be realistic, she says. Expect a miracle. What will be your cannonball moment in life? Or has it already happened? Fear not. Sages followed an unscheduled comet. They tumbled into heaven, haphazard by starlight. And so can we. Please stand to sing, O Come, All Ye Faithful. seated for our prayers. Let us pray.
Holy Child of Bethlehem, whose parents find no room in the inn, we pray for all who are homeless. Holy Child of Bethlehem, born in a stable, we pray for all who are living in poverty. Holy Child of Bethlehem, rejected stranger, we pray for all who are lost or alone. Holy Child of Bethlehem, whom Herod sought to kill, we pray for all in danger, all who are persecuted. Holy Child of Bethlehem, sought by those who left home to find you, we pray to learn courage for walking in the dark. Holy Child of Bethlehem, in you the Eternal was pleased to dwell. We pray to see the divine image in people everywhere. In your name we offer this prayer. Amen.
Will you please stand?
A reading from St. John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness to bear witness to the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness to that light. That was the true light which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe in his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh, dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. We remain standing, for hark the herald angels sing.
Thank you.
as we stand, the final blessing. May the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas. And the blessing of God Almighty, who is creator, sustainer, and redeemer, be with you and between you this night and forevermore. Amen.